Myself, Sami Nazar, and I will be continuing that application of Gauss's law. Before knowing the applications of Gauss's law, we should know what exactly Gauss's law are. So, sight is equal to Q enclosed. What this explains? The number of electric flux lines passing through a closed surface will be equal to the total charge enclosed by that surface. And we know psi is V dot ds. So we are having this. These are just overview of Gauss's law. How many the inverse law? It is also called Maxwell's first equation. And since these are in integral form, so it is called Maxwell's first equation in integral form. We have Maxwell's equation in point from and differential forms also. So how we will get that? We will apply divergence theorem. Before we go with the application of Gauss's law, we must be knowing how we apply these laws. There are certain steps that we follow. What are those steps? First of all, we check for symmetricity, though the charge distribution provided is symmetric or not. Symmetric. If it is symmetric, then we try to form a closed mathematical closed surface that we call Gaussian surface. Gaussian surface such as the electric flux density D should be normal to the surface or it should be tangential. This direction, tangential to the surface. Why normal? If this is normal, suppose this is ds going in this direction. So these both, this is D and this is ds. So these both lines are parallel to each other. When these are parallel, they form 0 degree and maximum will occur. I'll show you. So first we should choose whether B is normal. Normal to the surface. Normal or it should be tangential. If it is normal, go like this, go into this, D dot ds. So since these are parallel, cos theta will be 1. So we can write D ds. And for tangential, D dot ds, since theta will be 90 degree, so it will be 0. So these are the steps we should be considering before applying for Gauss law. Now I apply Gauss law for point charges. Applying Gauss law. Take a charge Q at the beginning and you need to find D at this point. What we will do? We will form a Gaussian closed surface. So for this point charge, this shape will be obviously spherical, will be the mathematical surface, closed surface that will be covering this Q. So we will take a sphere. And what will be the direction of D? It will be normal. What is the distance? This is distance R. This is P. P is point of observation. So according to Gaussian law, what we have, Q enclosed, that is Q here, will be equal to the D of D for this complete surface. And what will be the D? Put it as equation 1. D, it will be dr radially outward average. Okay. And we will substitute this in the charge. What is ds? So since it is a spherical surface, we know the differential surface for a sphere is r square sin theta d theta d theta. Now we will integrate the surface. Since it is constant, it will come outside and we substitute r square sin theta d theta d phi a r theta. normal vector. Phi we vary from 0 to 2 pi. How it is varying from 0 to 2 pi? For phi we take the circle at the surface. So we can make one complete 360 degree. Starting from there we can perform one complete rotation. So it is 0 to 2 pi. But for theta how will go? Will go along this horizontal axis. So from that degree to only semicircle can be drawn. So how will it take? We will take from 0 to 90 degree. 0 to pi 180 degree. So theta will be 0 to pi. R is constant. See, R is not changing here. R is constant. And then we'll put upper limit and lower limit, we'll get 2 pi and this will give minus 2 cos theta 0 to pi. So we draw one line chart here.